Hello everyone. I'm sure you have all looked at the night sky. When we go out in the open ground and look at the sky, we see a lot of stars in the sky. These stars appear to move over time because the Earth rotates around itself. Something like this. The stars are now setting. They form various patterns in the sky. It appears that all these stars are embedded on a sphere, an imaginary sphere, a transparent sphere around the Earth called as the celestial sphere. Let's talk more about this celestial sphere. But before that, let us look at the Earth from a bird's eye view and analyze its various motions and see how it is oriented in the space. This is our Earth as seen from space going around itself. This motion of Earth is called as rotation. The Earth rotates in around 24 hours around its own axis. This line is called as the axis of rotation of Earth. Looking from top, the Earth appears to rotate in an anti-clockwise direction. Perpendicular to this axis, passing through the center of this huge globe, is a plane which we call as the equatorial plane. This line represents the equatorial plane. The Earth has another motion. That motion is called as revolution. The Earth revolves around the Sun in a plane. This plane is represented by the green line. It is called as ecliptic. This is the plane in which the Earth revolves around the Sun. The rotation as well as revolution happens in the same manner. That is, when we look from above, both appear to move or in an anti-clockwise fashion. Now, an interesting thing to note is that the axis of rotation of Earth is not perpendicular to the plane of the Earth's motion around the Sun or the ecliptic. It is tilted with respect to the perpendicular at an angle of 23.5 degrees. So, this is the ecliptic plane, this is the perpendicular to the ecliptic plane, and the axis of rotation of Earth is tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees. Now, let us look at Earth, which appears to be inside a sphere called as the celestial sphere. So, what is this celestial sphere? As I was saying earlier, the celestial sphere is an imaginary, a transparent sphere of practically infinite radius on which all the stars appear to be embedded. One point to note here is that all the stars in the sky appear as point sources to us, and we cannot perceive the linear distance, the distance of these stars from the Earth. And hence, we think that they are embedded on this huge sphere around the Earth called as the celestial sphere. So, a celestial sphere is an imaginary sphere, a transparent sphere around Earth on which all the stars appear to be embedded and on which the planets, the Sun, the Moon appear to move. Now, let us define few more things which will help us to identify and define the position of all these objects, that is the star, the planets, the Moon, on this celestial sphere. For that, we will first define something called as the celestial equator. This blue sphere is the celestial sphere at the center of which we have Earth. You can see the white equator of Earth. When you expand this circle on the celestial sphere, you see this yellow circle which is called as the celestial equator. The equator on Earth is expanded on the sphere and it is called as the celestial equator. Again, just as we have the north and the south poles of Earth, we have the north celestial pole and the south celestial pole on the celestial sphere. Going ahead, we saw that the Earth goes around the Sun in a path, in a plane, which we call as ecliptic. From Earth, it appears that the Sun is going around the Earth during a day because of its rotation and during the year because of the annual motion. If we try to plot or if we try to draw this hypothetical path or the apparent path of Sun on the celestial sphere, we get this ecliptic. Ecliptic is the apparent path of Sun on the celestial sphere. And it is obvious that the ecliptic and the ecliptic on the celestial sphere and the celestial equator, they will make an angle of around 23.5 degrees with respect to each other. This can be easily proved by the fact that we know that the equator or the axis of rotation of Earth is tilted with respect to the perpendicular to the ecliptic at an angle of 23.5 degrees. On the celestial sphere here, you are seeing the yellow plane, which is the ecliptic plane or the plane of the Earth's motion around the Sun. The blue plane is the celestial equatorial plane, which is bounded by the celestial equator. These two are tilted with respect to each other at an angle of around 23.5 degrees that we have already seen. As we are seeing from Earth, it appears that the Sun goes around the daily and throughout the year. Daily because of the rotation of Earth and throughout the year because of the revolution of Earth. And we have already said that the ecliptic is the apparent path of the Sun on the celestial sphere. The celestial equator and the ecliptic cross each other at two points called as the vernal equinox and the autumnal equinox. Looking from above, we see that the Sun also moves on the celestial sphere along the ecliptic in an anti-clockwise manner, which is represented by these arrows. Let us say that Sun is somewhere here on vernal equinox. The Sun will start moving above the equatorial plane in the northern part and continue its journey northward. It will reach a maximum of 23.5 degrees north. At this point, we call it that the Sun is at the summer solstice point. The Sun continues its journey southward and it reaches a point called as the autumnal equinox. After autumnal equinox, the Sun goes further south below the celestial equator, and on 23rd December, it reaches the point here which is called as the winter solstice. The word equinoxes means the duration of day and nights are equal. So, on vernal and autumnal equinox, the duration of day and night on the entire Earth is same. On the other hand, when the Sun is at summer solstice, the northern hemisphere experiences the longest day and the shortest night of winter. On the other hand, when the Sun is at winter solstice, the northern hemisphere, we are talking about only the northern hemisphere right now, experiences the longest night and the shortest day. But what happens in the southern hemisphere? When the Sun is at summer solstice, at this point, that is 23.5 degrees north, the southern hemisphere experiences the longest night and the shortest day. On the other hand, when the Sun is at the winter solstice, the southern hemisphere experiences the longest day and the shortest night. All the four points are imaginary points on the celestial sphere. So how do we identify them? We identify these points with the help of constellations and other stars. We can pinpoint where these imaginary points will lie on the celestial sphere with the help of some of the stars and constellations. The other thing is, on vernal equinox, which is on 21st March, we say that the sun is on vernal equinox. On 21st June, which is the summer solstice, we say that the sun on 21st June is at the summer solstice. Sun is on the autumnal equinox on around 23rd September, and around 22nd December, the sun is near winter solstice. The question is, what are the uses of these points? These points help us to make something called as a coordinate system of the sky or the celestial coordinate system, which helps us give coordinates to each and every object in on the celestial sphere, let it be stars, let it be planets, let it be sun, let it be moon, and also help us track how these coordinates change over time. We will talk about celestial coordinate system in the next lecture.